But the story that's generating the most buzz around the NBA involves the cloudy future of the Houston Rockets, who look like they're about to become the Rockettes again. Houston is at the proverbial fork in the road. So how is this going to go, right? They're at a defining point. This is one of those Waterloo moments. Now, we've heard a lot of scuttlebutt that Houston is contemplating the, quote, nuclear option. What is that? That would be getting rid of both James Harden and Russell Westbrook, both of them. Bye-bye. See you later. Get out of here. Now, that is likely not going to happen. It's not off the table, but it's highly unlikely. It is likely, though, that there will be wholesale changes in Houston. Daryl Morey is no longer the sheriff in charge. They got a new guy and a new coach. And so James Harden, he is the one that supposedly now is locked in, the latest report, which is subject to change several more times. It'll flip like a coin. Heads, tails, right? And so now he's locked in, but tomorrow it might be different. There were also reports that he was ghosting the Rockets, James Harden, like he's a teenager dating another teenager. Now, for now, the expectation is that only Russell Westbrook will be repackaged before the NBA draft, which is next week, next Wednesday. This coming Wednesday is the NBA draft. Russell is said to want out of Dodge. Get me out of here. I'm Dunskies with the Rockets. So let us discuss the question. When you look at the dynamic in Houston, how much of this is James Harden, right? Now, we know Russell Westbrook was only there for a cup of coffee, a half a cup of coffee. How much of this is James Harden? How much of this was Russell Westbrook, this experiment lasting only one season? Well, this and pretty much everything involving the Rockets over the last 7 years or so, the beard, fear the beard. Now, I've got Muddy Waters, Playground, and Dungeons & Dragons. And we will lock all these things together, and we are going to make some Baba Ganoush. All right, now, James Harden has some explaining to do. Now, Houston, and listen, I got no skin in the game, right? I'm not a Houston guy. I've been attacked by our friends in Houston for being anti-Houston because I don't kiss the ass of the Houston teams like a lot of the local hacks in Houston do. But listen, the Rockets have a revolving door of star players that have tried to be that magical number two, the yin to the yang of James Harden. They have brought in an assortment of decorated NBA players, all of them at the time they were acquired, were deemed to have the perfect DNA to play with James Harden. It started with Dwight Howard, and he decided to leave the Lakers. No one leaves the Lakers, but God told him to go play for the Rockets. Apparently, God didn't consult James Harden because that didn't work out so well. And then that was a couple of years. Then Chris Paul was the next one. CP3, the Rockets traded their entire bench to get Chris Paul. And that was a hot mess. It didn't really work well together. And at the end, it was ugly. It's always ugly at the end. And then you got Russell Westbrook, former MVP, Russell Westbrook. And each one of these players, all three of them, Dwight Howard was in the NBA Finals with Orlando. Chris Paul was Lob City Clippers and all these assists he's put up. Russell Westbrook, the MVP, all these accomplishments. They joined the Rockets, high expectations, sky high, right? Arrow pointed up for all of them, and they had champagne wishes and caviar dreams and all this stuff. It was assumed that it would be a tiptoe through the tulips. Zippity-doo-da, zippity-day. How'd that turn out? Instead of swimming in the hot springs, they were swimming and stuck in muddy waters is what they were. In Houston, all of them ended up hitting the eject button, getting out of there and exiting stage right.
Ejected.
That's right. Now, number two, now the Rockets contender window, if you believe in such things, is narrowing. It used to be this big, and now it's down. You can't see my fingers, but it's a wee bit small, A wee bit smaller. Now, the one common denominator, you know what the one common denominator is with the Rockets over this stretch? That's right. James Harden. James Harden has scored a bunch of points. He's on the fast track to the Hall of Fame. All of that is true. But he has been the kid on the playground that does not want to share his toys with others. He does not want to play. He doesn't play well with others. He doesn't want to share. That basketball is guarded like the gold at Fort Knox. And it must be in his possession at all times. Now, we have heard of the classic coach killer, right? We've all heard of it in sports. The player that is brought in, high expectations, that sabotages the coach by not getting it done and also poisoning the locker room. So we've heard of that, but James Harden needs his own genre. He needs his own classification with what's gone on with all these decorated NBA players that have not been able to play alongside him, right? So seriously, because James Harden at this point is the epitome of the one-man show. He's omnipresent and a dominant offensive force with a rather aesthetically unpleasing style of basketball, unless you like watching foul shots. But he puts up the stats. So what would we call him? Like, what's the term? You got coach killer. He's not a coach killer, although they've had coaches. He's a star killer. He's like the Typhoid James of the NBA, right? Typhoid James seems like a good teammate on the outside, and yet he causes the power struggle with these other star players, the bickering, the dissension that leads to ultimately failure for the Rockets. And watching these many, many stars join James Harden, it's kind of like you're viewing images up in space, and you're at the Hubble Space Telescope, and you're watching exploding stars fade away. And all they do is get near James Harden, and kaboom, just like that. All right, final point. So you have a problem. Who are you going to call? The Ben Maller Show, right? What's the solution? What's the solution? James Harden, who is clearly set in his ways. And listen, I'm the same way. I'm pigheaded. I'm bullheaded. I'm not much different. I mean, I make my mind up. I stick to it. But there is no evidence that this latest Rockets turbulence is going to set off any kind of alarm bells, that they'll be changed, that this will be the wake-up moment. So what is the solution? All right, my advice, all right? This is 10 cent overnight radio advice. My advice, stop. Stop trying to get another big-name front man to team up with Harden. Doesn't work. You've tried it three times. Three strikes, you're out. James Harden is the only cook allowed in the kitchen. That's it. I know you need two or three superstars to win a championship in the NBA. That's how that league works. No. What the Rockets need to do is go find some Dungeon and Dragon-type players. Right? Roll the dice. Just like Dungeons and Dragons, you roll the dice, surround James Harden, okay, with inferior guys who will be very happy to play second fiddle. And so it's kind of like, instead of having prime rib, have the Salisbury steak and put that around James Harden. Bunch of bit players that'll do the grunt work. Typical rebounders, the rim protectors, those kind of guys. The non-glamorous parts of playing in the NBA, and just hope that Harden is so good offensively that it doesn't matter if he's got a bunch of stiffs offensively around him and he doesn't have to accommodate anyone, right? No, he doesn't worry about anyone there, and just put those grinder-type players out there, and James Harden can continue to have a motorcade to the foul line. You get a bunch of foul shots, 10, 15 a game there, and he can play at his tempo. Now, it's not going to work. The Rockets wouldn't win anything in the playoffs because you do need another quality option, a couple of quality options, but it's the only way to go. If you're going to keep Harden, and I'm still not convinced, by the way, they're going to keep James Harden. This is going to change four or five more times before the draft because you know the story's already being worked on and the comments will be posted on social media. Daryl Morey's making a Godfather offer for James Harden, right? The Philadelphia executive trying to steal Harden away from the Rockets. And so you know that's coming. Someone's going to toss out the Godfather offer, an offer you just cannot refuse to try to get James Harden. So then will the Rockets keep him or will they trade him? But if they keep him, then you have no choice. You trade Russell Westbrook and you just put a bunch of scrubs around him, a bunch of guys that'll grind it out and hope that Harden's enough and that's it. And it'll be fine during the regular season. And then in the playoffs, you'll be screwed.